Hey, I'm Anthony Romano, and this is the heavily requested keto bulk full day of eating slash 10 eggs a day full day of eating video. So this is going to be a fun video. You're going to learn a lot, and I encourage you to watch it all. And let's set a like goal on this one of 100 likes. That would make my day, and absolutely let me know that this is the type of content you want me to keep making, because it is a little bit more difficult to make. So I'm going to try to make parts of this really fun. There's going to be some workout footage, lots of cool stuff. So like it, subscribe, follow my Instagram, and watch this video multiple times over, because there's a lot you can pick up from it. Also, before we get into the video, I'm doing a ketone giveaway. So the rules are in the description, and basically it's very easy. You just have to follow me on Instagram, YouTube, send one of my YouTube videos to somebody, and then send me proof that you sent them one of my YouTube videos on Instagram. Read the rules to be certain on that, but giving away some of the best ketone supplements out there. And what else we got here? Yeah, that's basically it. Okay, enjoy the video. Without a weight check, and that is my Renfo scale. It's basically just like a little, you know, digital scale that will tell you enough about your body composition. And I get some clients to get it. It's a very cheap scale, link in the description. But at the end of the day, it gives you cool stats, and basically you can learn a little bit more about your body composition, and maintaining it becomes a lot easier. Besides the fact that you should already be doing, you know, keto, carb backloading, all that stuff to really maintain condition year round.
It's the keto bulk physique. Try to stay lean year round. This is about 175 for me. Well, exactly 175 for me. But I try to stay lean all the time and build from there. That's my lifting philosophy, if you will.
Okay, so now we're gonna get into some pre-workout supplements. I'm going to be making a bulletproof coffee in a few minutes, and then I'm gonna take some vitamin A, D, K, fat soluble vitamins with that, because I want the fats from the bulletproof coffee to actually provide a base for the A, D, K to digest it. But I'm going to actually be taking some Zynamite, which is this pure energy by Azoth. So I just partnered up with Azoth. I've always been promoting their stuff for free. And they've, you know, fortunately we've partnered up, and you can get a discount link in the description from me and Azoth. Fantastic ingredient right here is Zynamite. This is like on days where you want to crank out lots of work and lots of activity, just the pure Zynamite is best. And that's really why I'm going with it today. I'm also going to be taking some iodine. Okay, I have multiple iodine supplements. This is J. Crowe's Lugol's iodine. And basically, this is something that can change a lot of people's lives. However, you know, if you have any outstanding conditions, you probably should look into it more before you start taking it. But iodine is powerful stuff, and I do like to take it even when I'm bulking. I do like to fast even when I'm bulking. You don't have to conform to the basic rules of bodybuilding culture where, you know, eat 7 meals a day when you're bulking and have 4,000, 5,000 calories. You don't have to do that. So I'm still going to be intermittent fasting, getting this workout fasted, taking iodine, and of course taking the Zynamite as pure energy, the supplement. That's really going to set me off quite well going into the pre-workout. And I will throw in a little bit of this creatine hydrochloride, and of course a tiny, tiny bit of this Havoc 137 by Athletic Alliance. You know, nothing too crazy. I mean, you can see the ingredients there, but this is a powerful, balanced pre-workout. There's a little bit of BCA in there. Quite a lot for pump and for focus. So, you know, when I'm talking pre-workouts, in general, it is best to use as little as necessary. And basically, I will use maybe a teaspoon dose of this in combination with some iodine earlier, a bulletproof coffee, some Zynamite on a day where I really have to get some shit done. That's basically the gist of it. All right, got my bulletproof coffee, took some vitamin A, D, K, and gonna be sipping on a tiny bit of that pre-workout I showed earlier during the workout, just get a little bit more oomph while I'm actually in it. Some electrolytes, BCAAs, a little bit of pump boosters I'm a fan of. But yeah, gonna go pick up Felice and meet my buddy Sam and Yousif at the gym. We're gonna have a nice workout today. Holy, it is a crappy day. I'm gonna have to pick a gloomy and melancholic song to slap over this like remix part of the video. Bleeding through. Hey.
Hey.
What is up? I got it.
Comparing Russo 2012.
Hey, bro.
Bro.
Alright, so we got the boys. Felipe, Yousif, Samakos. Time for what? A nice back here.
Perhaps the strongest shoulders. The gods of Ketones.
Look at those arms. Look at those
amazing feet. Arms. The side chest hanging out of the tank top.
Yeah, those peaks are coming out of the tank.
That's the. Those are the Venus. Those are the Ketones peaks.
I don't want to stop because you guys just gassed me up.
The Ketones peaks.
Oh my god.
I've never seen somebody do dips with dumbbells.
Bro, that was actually impressive.
That's the workout.
Yes,
also, we have some news here. The boy Yousif has started a YouTube page amidst excessive demand.
Exactly.
So if you're into competitive bodybuilding, Yousif is a former competitive bodybuilder himself. He knows the industry. He knows the scene.
Yes,
and he's making a lot of videos comparing top bodybuilders, also talking about various tips.
Subscribe to my channel.
Yeah, show Yousif's page some love. The guy really knows his shit about bodybuilding, and he's breaking down a lot of top competition level athletes.
Absolutely. Meanwhile.
Oh, I saw it. This is right here.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
All right.
Follow the boy. There we go.
Yo, like, share, subscribe to my channel.
Make sure to follow this man.
All right, thank you guys.
Also, he's really funny.
I try.
And,
he's
cute.
Moments, you know what
he's
mean?
Cute.
I do have my moments.
He has a nice beard.
I'm not as cute as this guy, but you know, he's the Ketone guy.
Oh my god. So make sure you follow him and like his shit and follow him on Instagram too. Same for the boys. Russo, Samakos.
20 minutes later.
Alright, so I'm done the gym and I'm going to be having some whey protein, which is a great strategy for keto bulking. Not always the best, you know, thing to use in a cutting scenario, but I have an entire guide I wrote on that, which is free. You can get it in the link in the description.
basically you just have to sign up to my email list and you'll see all the different times and uses for whey protein, because the insulin spike can either help you or hurt you depending on your goal. So today I'm going to be using Rivalous Native Pro. This is basically the cleanest whey protein you can get from this brand. And like I said, I always try to promote the best quality stuff, and I will never endorse something unless it is of very good quality. So, you know, I'll show some different supplements here and there, but this is one that I actually do stand by for sure. Got a double scoop in here today because I'm really going for that anabolic response from the insulinogenic properties of whey. And you know what? This is the whey protein guide. I just happen to have a picture of it here. It looks like this. It's on my website. So what I'm doing is I'm not actually consuming any eggs yet. And for those of you who know the sort of egg bulking strategy I use, I'll basically use 10 to 15 eggs just because that's a manageable number per day in addition to whatever food I eat. And that's derived from the strategies of Vince Gironda, who was a golden era bodybuilding legend. And he coached a lot of the big classic bodybuilders. And basically he had this protocol where you would eat 36 eggs a day. And basically that would be comparable to a steroid cycle, according to him. Now, I didn't use 36 eggs because that was ridiculous, and my parents would kick me out of the house if I did that. So I started off with 10 a couple years ago, and that was a very good way to get some extra nutrition into my day. I find it's most useful because of the cholesterol in the egg, the fat-soluble vitamins, and some of the nutrients that you can only get in eggs. It's basically a complete protein, has all the essential amino acids. It's a great way to build up muscle building strategy. And also it has a high presence of leucine, which is one of the most anabolic amino acids. It's a BCA, and basically one of the primary dictators of muscle growth is leucine availability. So another great reason why, you know, the 10 eggs a day approach is great, but you can watch my entire video on that. Now, I do tend to have a lot of those eggs raw because it is an easier way to build up a calorie total and a protein total in a day where you're bulking and you're not trying to eat like a freaking behemoth. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm having this whey shake first because I want that to digest. It's a very fast digesting food, and you don't want to mix a lot of other food with a whey shake because that can kind of mess with the digestion. That's how people get the sort of gastric upset from whey protein when they're mixing it with things that digest at a different speed. That's one of the reasons why. Again, watch the video on that. But raw eggs, when I do have them raw, which I will be having some of them today raw, the digestion time is rather quick, around half an hour or so per raw egg. And they do digest very well that way and completely. But at the same time, I just want this quick digesting protein, especially a double scoop, to digest first. And then I'm going to have some raw eggs later, as well as my other meals. So that's kind of the gist behind what I'm doing currently. So, another note on the eggs. You always want to try to prioritize high quality eggs if you are going to use them. Realistically, you could just use this approach on any sort of bulking diet, and I do believe it is superior to a lot of other approaches where people are just slamming together, you know, high amounts of calories in a certain like smoothie or something like that. They're mixing macros that don't digest well together. You shouldn't mix carbs and proteins together. They digest in different stomach environments. Another thing I have an entire video on, but at the end of the day, it is a superior thing that you could just add in a couple more eggs to your day, but make sure they're high quality eggs. That is a key distinction here, okay? What you want to do is you want pasture raised. Those are the best quality eggs. Now you can also get organic, you can get anything. The better you can get, you know, you're playing your cards right, because you don't want to always have to rely on getting farm eggs, rely on getting high priced eggs at grocery stores or health food stores. So even if you go to a place that has organic or omega-3 eggs, that's probably the best you can find in a grocery store. There's a certain hierarchy of eggs, and the better you can get, the better you're going to play your cards. So in general, pasture raised is the best, but the closer your budget allows to organic, or you could say free run, but that's kind of like it could be misleading because it basically could just mean that the chicken had some space to move around. But you want the diet of the animal to be natural, and basically so that they're eating all the plants, seeds, insects that they would be eating, so that their nutrition of their egg comes out a lot better. And basically you can see this in the yolk itself. It'll look more orange. There's a lot of other defining qualities of the eggs that are higher quality. But basically, try to get good quality eggs, especially if you're going to be consuming more of them. That way you're basically eliminating all the wheat, soy, GMOs, corn that could be fed to the chicken and getting into their eggs. So a lot of people also have digestive intolerances to those foods, but at the same time, it's just you're, again, playing your cards as best you can by getting better quality eggs whenever your budget allows. All right, so one more thing before I show you some of the other meals I'm going to be eating today. I do have a lot on my plate, metaphorically and literally, because I am going to be running some more programs, talking with some more clients, some other business connections. But at the same time, what I wanted to talk about here was the reasoning behind why I still fast when I bulk. Maybe I should make a video on this too. But essentially, it's a very similar premise to the reasoning behind carb backloading. So carb backloading is basically where you will be in a ketogenic state and then you will have carbs, you know, on a certain day. And you could even slam as many carbs you want, even of the junk variety, provided you get the clean junk that I talk about, such as Belgian chocolate bar opposed to Snickers bar, right? You can still eat foods that are sort of junky, provided you get good quality, I guess organic, I'll say, ingredients. But that's kind of a simplification. But at the end of the day, the reason why carb backloading works is the same reason why fasting while bulking works. You're basically keeping your insulin low and you're heightening that sensitivity, and then you're gonna work out, really jack up that insulin sensitivity, and then slam insulinogenic proteins. And that's gonna create the maximum anabolic response that you're after. Especially if your daily total of protein and calories is adequate, you will be building muscle, okay? And that's essentially the gist behind why I still fast when I'm bulking. Now keep in mind, even if you are cutting, that's also a great strategy, but technically if somebody is cutting, they wouldn't be best advised to consume whey protein after a workout. I mean, definitely you will get better muscle recovery, but in excess it could be a problem and could basically prevent fat from being used as a fuel. So at the end of the day, it's not a make or break thing, but at the end of the day, the sort of removal of that insulin spike after already training in a low insulin state is going to maximize fat burn. And then after the workout, you're still going to replenish adequately, but you're not going to put as much emphasis on this sort of slamming the anabolic response with a double scoop of whey protein, and then a couple hours later having some more eggs, having some other protein dense foods, things of that nature.
Later.
And I'm also going to eat some of this smoked salmon. This is Norwegian salmon, and I got my little scale here. This is a great snack, and just plop a bunch on there. I weigh my food in general just so I have a good idea of how much I'm eating. You know, I'm not really meticulous about it, but that's how you should go about.
A few moments later.
Okay, so I'm about to go have my first batch of raw eggs, and I'm sure some of you are watching this thinking I'm a complete wacko for having raw eggs, but if you watch my other videos, I explain the concerns many people have about them and why they're ultimately not really a risk, provided you get good quality eggs and you're, you know, doing your due diligence with making sure the eggs are good quality. So essentially, the reason I'm bringing this up is because of digestion. Now, bulking is a very digestively taxing process, and nobody seems to talk about this. When you're having a very high calorie diet anyways, you're gonna be dedicating like 30% of your calorie expenditure to just simply digesting food anyways. So this is another reason why handling your bulking in a manner that is minimizing the digestive taxation is going to be allowing you to eat less calories technically. Of course, you still have to eat a good amount of calories, but it's something that's not really as much of a concern. You always have to be mindful of what foods you're digesting together and the environment of your stomach. So on keto bulks, this is ultimately not too big of an issue because you're generally not combining the number one mistake that people make, which is combining protein and carbs, because they digest in proteins within an acidic environment, carbs within a more alkaline environment. So when you combine the two, you're ultimately risking improper digestion of both. And that's another reason why keto bulking is my go-to, besides the fact that it allows me to stay lean and feel great, blah, blah, blah. So when we're talking about digestive environments, this is why I'm having the raw eggs first. I'm having them, and then I'm gonna have about 6 or 7 raw eggs, high quality eggs. I'll show you the box. And essentially, I'm going to have some cooked eggs later. It's more so about the total amount of eggs because the nutrients within the eggs are beneficial. Now, granted, I'm not a doctor, and I'm saying this little disclaimer here because I know this is technically, you can't market eggs as a health food, funny enough. There's regulations on that. Completely biased, and it's based off of the cholesterol lipid hypothesis from the 1940s or 50s. So it's complete fallacious logic, but at the end of the day, this is why you want to have eggs. It's not because there's some sort of magical properties to having them raw. It's simply because it allows you to get more food in without having to tax your digestive system, without having to eat abundant amounts of food, okay? So I'm going to go have some raw eggs, and I'll show you the carton, and then I'm going to have some cooked ones later, some steak, maybe a handful of macadamia nuts, and that'll probably have me set for the evening. These are the eggs I get. It's time to down them.
Tonight, down on the suburbs tomorrow.
Okay, it's about 9:30 p.m. I'm gonna have my last meal of the evening. This is a little bit later than I would like it to be. And I'm basically going to eat some eggs, like a nice omelet, some steak, which I'm going to cook up, some nice grass-fed steak. And if I had some more wine, I would have some wine. But that's not something I have every day. Now, as far as overall bulking tips, I'm about to drop you a huge one right now. Because the main reason I'm bringing up timing of the last meal is you generally want to have your meals in any diet, let alone a bulking one where you're digesting a lot of food, around 3 to 4 hours removed from your bedtime, because this is going to allow your brain to run the glymphatic system better. Now, what the hell is glymphatic system? It's basically your brain's cleaning of waste that happens while you sleep. And if your blood sugar's out of whack, if your insulin's out of whack from a big meal before bed, not only are you gonna wake up, and by the way, if you're already waking up in the middle of the night, it's probably from an insulin spike, but essentially you want insulin and blood sugar spikes to be removed from bedtime, and the way you accomplish that is by eating your last meal with some space before bed. In general, that's also going to allow your food to get digested properly and your sleep to be optimized. If you have an Aura ring or something like that, you will notice better sleep quality, more REM sleep, more deep sleep. And this is, of course, important for bulking and building muscle. But the main thing is you're going to sleep better and everything's going to go according to plan. And a lot of people, when they're on any sort of bulking diet, they'll basically just be stuffing their face all day long. And besides the fact that they're already taxing their digestive system, they're going to be going to bed on a full stomach. And this is not what you want. You're not going to get the best of both worlds if you do that. So another reason why keto bulking is something that I find very easy to stick to and find balance in. So I'm going to show you my last few meals. It's going to be a handful of macadamia nuts, nice omelet, and some steak. And besides that, I do have a couple other supplements I will take at night, mostly a ZMA complex I'm a big fan of, nice zinc, magnesium. I like that one as well because it has some chromium in there. And I'm also going to take some apple cider vinegar to help my protein-dense meals at the end of the evening digest a little bit better. And that will also help with minimizing blood sugar spikes before bed. So there's a lot of little things that I will throw in to a lot of things, but this is further info to make the best bulking strategies available to you, regardless of what kind of diet you want to do. Even if you think my whole egg bulking thing is crazy, I'm telling you, you got to start incorporating in any context this sort of removal of food between 3 to 4 hours from bedtime. That's really going to help you out in a lot of ways, and it will help you also get on a better sleep schedule. But again, those are some better bulking tips.
Omelet time, I got my ghee, which is always grass-fed. This is like a superfood. I have an entire video on this. You have to watch it. But it's great to use as a stable fat for cooking. And of course, it also gives a nice taste to the eggs. And I'll even put a little bit of grass-fed butter or ghee on my eggs sometimes, especially when I'm removing dairy towards the end of a cutting phase. The main thing is that ghee is devoid of the main milk proteins that are in most dairy. So here's my omelet. It's 4 eggs with some grass-fed butter on top. That's probably about a tablespoon extra. And of course, I'll be showing my calorie and macro totals at the end of this video. But this is actually putting me at 11 eggs for the day. And of course, there's no problem with that if you have good quality eggs. I did use a couple of just the other free-run eggs I have from Costco in this omelet, but at the end of the day, it's still the majority from high quality source, and this is gonna taste really nice, so I'm gonna enjoy it. Now, another thing too is I will take a digestive enzyme with my biggest meal of the day whenever I'm bulking, and given that I had my eggs maybe a half hour ago, I'll still throw one in here because this is a lot of food, and I still am gonna go to sleep in about 4 hours. Also, I will throw in some apple cider vinegar. This is the best stuff. Bragg's apple cider vinegar, unpasteurized, unfiltered, raw. This tastes terrible, but it works. And it's great for blood sugar control, for digestion if you have low stomach acidity. Especially when you're digesting a lot of protein in one meal, you're going to want more acidity in your gut. At least, unless you're like massively acidic in your stomach. Now I have my grass-fed steak. This is, let's see exactly how many grams this is. So I got my scale again. 250, so about 250, 300 grams of steak. And this is, again, high quality steak. It's just a little bit left over I had from a big one I cut up earlier this week. Time to whip this up. There we go. That stuff's way worse
than downing raw eggs, okay? That's the craziest thing I've done in this video. So you might be thinking, Anthony, why'd you have the apple cider vinegar without a straw? And the answer is because even with the straw, it can still damage your teeth. If you want nice teeth, and you don't want them to be destroyed by the acid in the apple cider vinegar, then I recommend either squirting a little bit of meal flavoring in there or just downing it back after putting 2 tablespoons into a cup and then chasing it with some water. That's not a good way to go too. So for my last meal, this is kind of a snack at this point. I'm just gonna throw a little bit of macadamia nuts, about 50 grams worth, and snack on that a little bit before it even hits 10 p.m. And that's gonna last me quite a while. Normally I'll have this meal a little bit earlier, but that's the way it goes. So that is all my meals for the day. Let's take a look at the total calories and macros. And you're gonna see that I'm not in that much of a calorie surplus, and that's good. I like it that way. You're trying to be lean while you bulk. You're not trying to get fat. You're trying to build quality muscle, and you don't need a shitload of calories to do that. And basically what we have here, I have my salmon, my whey protein. I put a different brand there just because the macros are the same and I couldn't find the exact protein powder. Macadamias, 50 grams. Steak, 2.5 grams. And, well, kilograms, and 11 eggs total, 7 raw, 4 in an omelet, and then ghee. I basically had a tablespoon of ghee, a tablespoon of butter, and 6 slices. It says 2, but it's 6 slices of turkey breast in my omelet. So essentially, my total calories for the day is 2,500. My total carbs says 23, but realistically, it's adding 11 carbs from eggs, which realistically, you're not getting much sugar in eggs at all or carb at all. So it's basically, let's subtract 11 from that. Let's call it 12 carb total. Fat, 158 grams, which is quite hefty, and 231 grams of protein. So I'm looking at about a 40-60 split of macros. And remember, this does not have to be the exact and only way to do a keto bulk. This is just to show you how it can look, okay? You can make this go your own way. I've seen people who do this even in very vegetarian style with eggs and not as much meat, with macadamias, okay? Other things like that, not necessarily saying it's as good, but the egg bulking is the way to go, in my opinion, for all lean bulks. And there are plenty of videos where classic bodybuilders would do this. They would even be forced to do it with 36 eggs at one point or another, okay? Now, another thing I want to add is you also have the option to carb backload on a keto bulk. You have the option to use carbs strategically and around your lifestyle. And that's why I talk about these topics so much, because carbs are your tool. They're a luxury tool in nature, and this is how our body was meant to live for large parts of the year. And if the human body wasn't able to build muscle during that time, then we probably wouldn't have made it that far. So that was my macro totals for the day. Another thing I want to add is that as long as your training is adequate, you will be making gains, okay? The body has to adapt to stressors, and it's not like you need 7,000 calories to make that happen, okay? Especially when you're using fat as a primary fuel here, it is an energy-dense fuel, and getting the total of 2,500 calories with adequate protein, I might have even overshot protein. This is like one of my heftier keto bulk days. Most of the time I keep it very lean. My calories and protein don't reach as quite of high of a ceiling as they did today. So use this to understand how keto bulks can work and make your lifestyle take the lead. Alrighty, so it's been about 2 hours since my last meal. It's 10:54 and I'm digested enough at this point where I'm comfortable having some evening supplements just to help me wind down a bit while I work on some books I'm writing currently. So stay tuned for those. And what I'm gonna have is this ZMA, this is zinc magnesium complex, the one I was mentioning before with the chromium and all the other minerals, and a couple other cofactor vitamins like B6, and also B12 in there too, in small amounts, but of the right forms, methyl forms. And essentially, I don't know why Mutant just went all out on this zinc magnesium supplement, because I'm not a fan of their other supplements that use a lot of artificial dyes, artificial sweeteners, but for some reason, this thing is just the best ZMA I've ever encountered. And also, I'll throw in a little tiny bit of melatonin, like some sublingual melatonin under the tongue. I'll have about 1 milligram worth of this, you know, more so on days when I need to adjust my sleep timing a bit. But this stuff is good to have in advance of bedtime to help you get tired in a few hours. And I'll also take a little bit of kava. So basically, a lot of people, well, not too many people talk about kava, but it can help create GABA in your brain, which is the relaxing neurotransmitter. And it's a natural way to do that. And essentially, I will use a little bit of this on some days. I find it improves my sleep quality. And also, I'll bring out these funky, you know, keto guy nerd glasses, and those help a lot when you're writing or looking at a computer screen from point blank. So I also have my soccer guy headband, my Francesco Totti circa 2006 hairstyle going on. So I look like an absolute wacko in this video, but this is how my night usually concludes. And you know, on a day where you're keto bulking, you want to get the best quality sleep you can. So that's what I'm about to do after I do some work. But I hope you enjoyed this video. This should be a very powerful video for you. And I hope you rewatch it over and over again. I hope you share it. I hope you learned a lot. And I hope that you also join my ketone giveaway, which is basically send a video to somebody, follow me on Instagram and YouTube. And maybe you can send them this video because it's a great video. And I really want it to blow up and get the, you know, reward for all the effort I put into this one. So hopefully you enjoyed it. Let me know if you do like it. I want to get to 100 likes on this one. And besides that, thank you for watching. My name is Anthony Romano. Peace.